Welcome back to Getting Stuck in Fucking Walls. I'm Duke of the Bump. Witness my rage. Witness my anger. Witness me try to play this stupid level again. Did I get stuck in exactly the same place as the first time? I really hope not. And I really hope I don't get stuck there again. I mean, I was trying to figure out how to get up to, like, this place that maybe perhaps had some stuff. But, alas, it wasn't to be. So, if I can just get through it this time, that'll be enough for me. I don't care about the stuff. I just want to not get stuck in the wall. Is that so much to ask, Sonic Megamix? Is that so much to ask? Let me ask you a question. And then I hit you in the head with an axe. Cue laugh track. I think that would make a pretty good show. It's part of a pilot for a sitcom I'm writing. It's called Let Me Ask You a Question. See, the premise of the show is there's this axe, you see? And the main character enjoys hitting people with the axe, usually in the head. And his catchphrase is, get this, let me ask you a question. And then, you know, everybody laughs and learns a lesson about sharing and humility, and I make $1 million. Just a little project I'm working on. You know, I've got numerous things on the back burner. I wonder if I could actually break through this with the dash. You know, the fan is just too powerful. You know, the amazingly fast speed of Sonic the Hedgehog is no match for a fan. It's not even an oscillating fan. It's just a non-oscillating fan. It's just the fan, or the big fan, starring that guy from that show. Why can I never remember his name? He was, oh no, this is the place. I'm not gonna fall into that trap again. Oh no. Although I got up there on the first try somehow. And Perp's talking to me, but he's... What? The... Fuck! Okay. Ugh. Take two. I'm Duke of the Bump. And if I get stuck in this wall one more time, just one more time, I don't think it was the same wall that time. I think it was a different wall. And it happened because I was on a curving slope thing, and I attempted to do a ring dash. That's why it happened. So I just need to lay off the A button, and lay off the crack, in that order, and I'll be good to go. What is that guy's name? The movie was called Big Fan, I think. I do know that. And I hear it's pretty good. And, it's about some guy in football. And that's all I really know about it. But, I can't think of that guy's name. He's a pretty good comedian. He was in, The King of Queens, was it? I keep wanting to call him Patrick Warburton, but he was the guy who played the Tick in that shitty live-action Tick show. Patrick something. Or something Warburton. Or something completely different. Oh, we've been here before. Yes, indeed we have. I remember a simpler time when video games didn't involve me playing the same areas over and over again because of a glitch. It must be because I have unlucky 13 lives. I mean, that's the only logical explanation. Didn't I just get that one up? Or was that a different one up? Did it reappear? No? I must be losing my mind. Maybe his name was Joe something. No. Kevin Spacey? No. Kevin Nealon? No, he was the guy in Weeds. Which is a pretty good show. God, I wish I had Wikipedia in my brain. I mean, I have it on my phone, which is almost as good. You know, something else that I always have access to. but I can't whip out my phone while I'm, you know, LPing. I mean, that's a sign of an unprofessional if I've ever seen one. Alright, I'm coming up on... I don't know where it is. I don't know how I'm supposed to get up there if I don't do the ring dash. And I don't know where I'm supposed to go if I don't get up there. Quite the quandary, I would say. Maybe... okay, I guess I'll go this way. Okay, yeah, this is a viable alternative. God, I feel like I've been playing this level forever. It's giving me so many 1-ups, too. Oh, that first 1-up I got was from rings. I didn't even realize I had more than 100 rings, because it's been such a rare occurrence for most of these videos. Where the... Now see, this I don't like. I don't like having to figure out where I need to go next in the Sonic game. I mean, I'm not playing freaking Zelda, for crying out loud. Or La Mulana. I shouldn't have to consult the walkthrough. Oh yeah, this is where I kept getting stuck. And here, it wasn't because I was doing the ring dash, it was just because that's a shittily designed area. Alright, see if I can make it past this other thing that I got stuck in. No ring dash. No ring dash there either, just to be on the safe side. And I just... fucked up the screen. It's too bad Ola Lilia isn't watching, because he'd appreciate that. He could probably tell me how many frames per second I was going, how many frames off the screen I was, calculate my velocity, design a game around it. Ola Lilia is the man. He's what all we autistic people aspire to be. Because I have autism, according to Perpetual Ascent. That's what he said. Quote, "You have autism. Perpetual Ascent." No, he didn't say that. I said that in the chat room once, just as a joke. Let's see if I can survive for more than 2 seconds this time. See, the reason I gravitated towards the beginning is because it had the elusive extra life block. See, in the Sonic 1 manual, it described all the blocks in the special stage and what they do. And there was one with a picture of Sonic that said 1-up or extra life or something. And it was crazy because you never actually saw it in the special stage. It doesn't actually exist. But if you use the debug code, then you can travel outside the boundaries of the special stage, and there are all kinds of them out there. But they don't give you 1-ups. Oh no. Is Michael... what were they thinking? Why would they put Michael Jackson... That was smart. Michael Jackson music. Like, not even Sonic 3 Michael Jackson music. Just Michael Jackson music in general. Why would they put it in this game? I don't get it. They probably got the track from Michael Jackson's Moonwalker or something. What is it with Michael Jackson tainting the things I love? I mean, I love Sega, and he tainted that. I love The Simpsons, and he tainted that. Michael Jackson just... I mean, apparently, you know, he couldn't molest me as a kid, so he molested my childhood memories instead. Boy, that was really melodramatic. I should stop. I'm probably pissing off a lot of Michael Jackson fans. For what it's worth, I don't know if the guy actually molested any kids, and, you know, he was never convicted, so I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. But, I mean, I'm still not a fan. The music was atrocious. So, yeah, if you're a Michael Jackson fan, I apologize, but, you know, you shouldn't care what other people think about entertainment that you enjoy anyway. I wonder if the fire shield protects me from this stuff. Nope, I didn't get hit. Probably would have hit me. I know in Sonic and Knuckles, some projectiles bounce off the fire shield. Whoa! Not spiky ones, though. But yeah, I mean, what do you care if some guy on the internet likes different music than you do? Big whoop. I mean, it's not a personal attack on you. And I hate people who, like, react that way.
Hey, shut up, man. You better stop talking smack about Battlefield Earth. That's my favorite movie. John Travolta's the man. Scientology forever, man.
And, like... Whoa. I phased through the loop. But yeah, the moral of the story is chill out. Chillax. Take a chillaxative. It'll be good for you. Wow. This is actually really fun. I'm just holding down the down button. See how much longer this can keep up. Apparently pretty long. Alright, it's been about 11 minutes. I'll pause it here. See you guys later.